with thee. Grant it, my God, if you please. Daily walking close with thee. Let it be, dear God, let it be. You know, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, family. Welcome to the Mental House. Y'all like that? Yeah, I just want to remind y'all that it was Sunday morning, and that's usually what we do on Sunday. Actually, I was sitting here reminiscing about not just the narcs that are involved with all the religious epithets, as they say, edifices. You know, I just start thinking about my childhood. While I usually try to focus on everything, you know, that was positive in it. That's the way I get through the day. But when I begin to think about a lot of the craziness that started in my life, I have to admit that it started right there in that damn church house. The bumping and grinding and all that stuff. It's, man, oh, you know, it's really sick. And of most of the people that's in the church house, that's running to the church every Sunday, they can't wait to get there. They the first ones that need to be in line for some real salvation. I want to share with y'all two stories. And I'm going to leave the names out. Because not only do I not have permission to use their names, they haven't been charged with any crimes or anything. And unless somebody blows a whistle, then I guess that they are content the way they are and what has happened. Well, the first thing I want to talk about is, it's kind of hard for me to talk about this without mentioning names. So I'll just suffice it to say, there was a bishop. There was one bishop, and he had a lot of kids. And when he got sick and saw himself being frail, he let his daughter and his son co-parent, kind of like Cleopatra and her brother Ptolemy. You know, they were both supposed to rule, and Ptolemy didn't want to rule with Cleopatra, so he went to war with his sister. And this is pretty much what happened. I actually watched it happen. And the sister was pretty much ostracized or talked about in church, called names. This is insane. Because the alpha male wanted the church for himself. And once the old man had passed, he didn't want to co-parent with his sister. So he began to slander her and, you know, call her all kinds of names, including lesbians and all types of stuff he did. So the sister ultimately let go of her part in being part of the church. She just didn't want it anymore. She couldn't stand the scrutiny. She couldn't stand co-parenting with him. I mean, not co-parenting, co-pastoring with him. And I think that she thought that that was probably one of the worst decisions that the old man had made. Instead of just calling somebody outright, was to have them co-parent. The unfair part about it is the daughter had been by the dad's side her whole life. She never, ever left. Never, ever left church. She was there from the inception, from her birth, and she's still there now. But, not in that particular church, but so she never left. Let's just want to make sure we can get the story correct. But the son pursued a a secular music career in L.A., and he was out there with a band for a while, and, you know, they did what they could do, but, you know, of course, there's so many bands out in L.A. Y'all know what the deal is out in L.A. Anybody that ever pursued anything and been out there, you know, it's just, it's crazy. And if that's what you want, if that's your get down, okay. Well, they quickly just learned that it was show and business, and so they couldn't handle it, and he ended up back. So that's when he joined the church and became devout, because he realized that was his hustle. And one thing I could say about the sun reminds you of that. I don't know if y'all seen Which Way Is Up, when the old preacher, dun, 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 they all carrying my seeds. Dun, 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 dun. You remember he got all the women in the church pregnant? Well, you can imagine that's the kind of scenario was going on in the church after the old man left. In fact, it had got so bad that the guy was standing out over the pulpit. And since I didn't mention no name, I don't even have to say allegedly. I can just let it rip. He would pull out his penis and let each one of these missionaries, evangelists, and saints of the Lord, saints of the Lord, they'd be sitting around sucking dude off on the pulpit. He'd go each one and let them do their thing. You want to know how I know? Because somebody left there because they was having sex with the preacher, and he put a he wanted to use objects, and then he stuck a colostrum a bottle and objects up her behind to the point where she needs a colostrum bag. I want to tell y'all about the church house, church house, church house. It's probably going on in any church USA. And just like the damn Catholic Church, black folks can't say shit about what's going on. That's what the whole thing is made out of. The Father, the Son, and a holy damn ghost. Okay? Whatever that is, I think it's a sex demon. Then, I got another bishop. He just passed away, too. Both of these bishops are dead, you know. And he impregnated women in his congregation. He had some of them out there horn. They used to sell candy 7 days a week. He used to talk to them like a pimp. Yes, all the candy you sold. The only thing he was mentioning was bitch. Bitch, that's all you got? Bitch, that's all you brought in the church? That's the only thing he didn't say. You take the bitch off of it, and everything else was pimp style. Pimp style. This is insane. And when these things come into my memory when I'm exercising and doing things, because as I'm just recovering from all the damn church people and the dogma, I really realized that y'all done drove a whole lot of damn people crazy. And if anybody's out there that's in a crazy church right now, and if y'all doing some of that shit with your pastor, I'm telling you right now, if it's a hell below, you going in a handbasket. Because you know the first lady is there. You don't get no two dams about the first lady. You just want to get dick down by Reverend Dick'em Down. How dare you? How dare you do the first lady like that? How dare you do her family like that? How dare you do the church members like that? And how dare you stand up and think that you find some kind of favor with anything that you call a higher power or respectable? That's evil right there, what you're doing. Okay? Now, thank God I ain't never did that one. I done did some crazy stuff, but that one I've never done. I ain't dick down the pastor. Because that is really crazy. I mean, okay, by the way, let me keep it moving. I digressed. This pastor, whose wife just recently died, And I'm sure she knows all about her husband's exploits and stuff in church, because he, you know, again, had children on her in a church. She's the first lady. But they had a son that was my age, and it was a friend of mine. In fact, he was one of my best friends growing up. And he was very talented, and he could sing his ass off. You know, when I talk about it, I get a little lump in my throat. And a lot of you guys know him. He's no longer here. And the same way with another prominent keyboard player. Both of them made it to the top of their game, pretty much, in their fields. One of them as a musician and one as a singer. But he passed away and he had AIDS. And because the people in church were embarrassed by him contracting AIDS, they didn't even really have, they ain't had no funeral. And the mention of it in the newspaper was so small, you would have never thought, you wouldn't even know he passed away, because he was in LA and they had to ship the body back. That was just to mention that he died. It wasn't how he lived. Put it like that. And then the other one that was a prominent musician, his mother was one of the women that go around screwing all the pastors. She was a whore. And a church whore. So I guess that makes her a special type. Her son played the keyboards behind some of the top musicians on the charts today. And like I said, and I mean the top musicians. He was bad. He was cold. He's played with a lot of individuals. And he's since passed on, my brother. And his mom didn't want to have a funeral for him at all. It took a few people to just convince her that it wasn't right, that he was beloved by people all over the world. And because he died the way he died, and now that she had control of his body, his corpse, she chose to try to alienate and ostracize everybody that loved him, until people was coming, you know, at her like, you know, you're not gonna do that. You can't do that. He deserved more. He deserved more. And I think that she might have thought that she might have been her life might have been threatened if she didn't have some kind of ceremony. I really do believe that, because she stayed in the back room the whole time, and they used a pretty prominent church here in the city that I live in, and they had his funeral, and she stayed in the back. She didn't want to come out. These people got the nerve to act like they're embarrassed by some of the behavior or whatever her son did to a lifestyle he led. But I contend that if he was in the prison of watching the hypocrisy like I did every day, I'm surprised that I have some sanity left. I think the only thing that balanced it off for me is that I had the Nation of Islam. And y'all can say what y'all want to say, and I don't agree with everything. But I must admit, all that raping and all that kind of sex activity and all that madness, that was all that was going on in the church. And I have to give an account. That stuff wasn't going on. I didn't experience any of that in the mosque. Any of it. I'm not saying it wasn't going on. I wouldn't bet my life on anything but like that. But I will say this. This show wasn't overt and covert, and nobody knew, because it never happened to me. And I've never can give an experience for anybody that I know that was in the Nation of Islam and come out and say that they were raped by anybody there. I just haven't heard it. Okay? So, I'm not saying they might not have got you in some other ways. I have a friend once that went to the Nation of Islam, and because of the truth that they were spitting out, he couldn't handle it. He just, you know, he just couldn't handle it. And I'm just going to leave it and suffice it to say that. But it wasn't anything that had anything to do with anything sexual. So on this Sunday morning, I want to tell everybody that's in any kind of church house dealing with narcissistic type of people that are being one way at home. Oh my God. Like a tyrant and a dictator and anything that you can name oppressive type of person. And then when they get to church house, they become God incarnate. Anybody that's got to live up under that type of hypocrisy, I feel for you right now. And you don't have to live like that. At some point, you're going to have to bust out. You're going to have to bust out. And that's just what it is. Okay. So, I don't know. This Sunday was a little reflective for me. And I thought about my friends. And for some reason, I wanted to pay homage to those two brothers today. I'm going to say J for the first one. And I'm going to say B, like J and B, for the second one. I love y'all very much. And I know y'all around me. You guys were some of the most talented individuals that I'd ever known. And your lifestyle and how your body left this earth is really not a concern for me. I'm just glad that y'all left beautiful music. And every time I think about the gifts that God gave, I'm glad that you use them to the fullest. Okay? That's just how I feel. And that was an impromptu video. And I hope y'all understand. So those of y'all on y'all way to church house this morning, don't go there and be no damn hypocrite. Okay? Go there and when you go, tell me what you're really getting out of it besides an emotional elixir. You know? And I really want you to challenge yourself. And if you're still talking about stuff that happened 2,000 years ago, and that is the crux of the lesson. When you got things happening right now that's destructive and terrible and tearing up our society and our community, and we ain't talking about that, then your church is dead. It's like dead man's bones. Okay? And you need something to blow some life on those dead bones so they can come alive again. Alright. So, thanks for listening. If you like what you hear, please like and subscribe. And I didn't mean to offend any of you church people, but if you got it, damn, oh well. What can I say? I'm a PK. I have the right to tell it like I see it. Okay. See you next time in the mental house.